Dwayne Johnson. Dwayne Douglas Johnson, born May 2, 1972, also known by his ring name The Rock, is an American actor, producer, and semi-retired professional wrestler. Johnson was a professional wrestler in the WWE for 8 years prior to becoming a full-time actor in 2005. Since then, he has become one of the top-grossing and highest-paid actors in the world. Johnson was a college football player for the University of Miami, with whom he won a national championship in 1991. He initially aspired for a professional career in football and entered the 1995 NFL draft but went undrafted. Johnson then signed with the Calgary Stampeders of the Canadian Football League, CFL, but was cut from the team in the middle of his first season there. Shortly after, he began training as a professional wrestler. In 1996, Johnson secured a contract with the WWE when it was known as the World Wrestling Federation, WWF, and was promoted as the first third-generation wrestler in the company's history, as he is the son of Rocky Johnson and grandson of Peter Mavia. He rose to prominence after developing a charismatic persona of a boastful trash-talking wrestler named The Rock. He subsequently won his first WWF Championship in 1998 and helped usher the WWF into the Attitude Era, a boom period in the company's business in the latter 1990s and early 2000s, which still hold professional wrestling records for television ratings. In 2004, he left the WWE to pursue an acting career and went on a 7-year hiatus before returning in 2011 as a part-time performer until 2013. Considered to be one of the greatest professional wrestlers and biggest draws of all time, The Rock headlined the most bought professional wrestling pay-per-view event, WrestleMania XXVIII, and was featured in some of the most watched WWE Raw and WWE SmackDown television episodes ever. He has won several championships, being a 2-time Intercontinental Champion, a 5-time Tag Team Champion, and a 10-time World Champion. He was also a Royal Rumble match winner and WWE's 6th Triple Crown Champion. Johnson had his first theatrical acting role in The Mummy Returns, 2001, and played his first lead role in the spin-off The Scorpion King, 2002. He went on to star in numerous other films, including The Rundown, 2003, The Other Guys, 2010, Mona, 2016, and Jumanji, Welcome to the Jungle, 2017. Johnson's most successful box office role has been a recurring role as Luke Hobbs in the Fast and the Furious movies. He first appeared as the character in Fast 5, 2011, and helped catapult the film series into one of the top-grossing movie franchises in history. Johnson has also attained success as an author and producer. In 2000, he released an autobiography titled The Rock Says, which debuted at number 1 on the New York Times bestseller list. In 2012, he founded his production company, 7 Bucks Productions, which has since produced several films, consistently ranked among the world's highest paid actors. 20. Johnson made the Time 100 Most Influential People in the World list in both 2016 and 2019. Early life. Johnson was born on May 2, 1972, in Hayward, California, to Otto Johnson, née Mavia, B.1948 closing parenthesis, and former professional wrestler Rocky Johnson, born Wade Douglas Bowles, B.1944. Growing up, Johnson briefly lived in New Zealand with his mother's family, where he attended Richmond Road Primary School in Gray Lynn before returning to the United States. He then attended Montclair Elementary School in Charlotte, North Carolina before moving to Hamden, Connecticut, where he spent a couple years at Shepherd Glen Elementary School and Hamden Middle School. Johnson spent his high school years in Honolulu, Hawaii at President William McKinley High School, in Nashville, Tennessee at Glencliff High School and McGavock High School, and in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania at Freedom High School. He was arrested multiple times for fighting, theft, and check fraud before the age of 17. Johnson also began playing sports, joining his high school's gridiron football, track and field, and wrestling teams. Football career. Johnson was a promising football prospect and received offers from many Division I collegiate programs. He decided on a full scholarship from the University of Miami, where he mostly played defensive tackle. In 1991, He was on the Miami Hurricanes national championship team. After suffering a number of injuries, he was later replaced in the starting lineup by future Pro Football Hall of Famer Warren Sapp. After Johnson graduated in 1995 with a Bachelor of General Studies in Criminology and Physiology, he signed with the Calgary Stampeders of the Canadian Football League as a linebacker. He was assigned to the practice roster, but was cut 2 months into the season. Professional wrestling career. Early career, 1995-1996. After his football career, Johnson decided to pursue a career as a professional wrestler. Veteran wrestler Pat Patterson got Johnson several tryout matches with the World Wrestling Federation, WWF, in 1996. Under his real name, he defeated the Brooklyn Brawler at a house show and lost matches to Chris Candido and Owen Hart. After wrestling at Jerry Lawler's United States Wrestling Association as Flex Kavanaugh and winning the USWA World Tag Team Championship twice with Bart Sawyer in the summer of 1996, Johnson signed a WWF contract. He received additional training from Tom Pritchard, alongside Akeem Albrecht and Mark Henry. World Wrestling Federation/Entertainment. Debut and Intercontinental Champion, 1996-1997. Johnson made his WWF debut as Rocky Maivia, a combination of his father and grandfather's ring names, although his real name was acknowledged by the announcers. He was initially reluctant to take this ring name, but was persuaded by Vince McMahon and Jim Ross. He was given the nickname the Blue Chipper, and his lineage was played to on TV, where he was hyped as the WWF's first third-generation wrestler. Maivia, a clean-cut face character, was pushed heavily from the start despite his wrestling inexperience. He debuted on Monday Night Raw as a member of Mark Mero's entourage on November 4, 1996. His first match came at Survivor Series, on November 17, in an 8-man elimination tag match. He was the sole survivor and eliminated the final two members of the opposing team, Crush and Goldust. On February 13, 1997, he won the Intercontinental Championship from Hunter Hearst Helmsley on Monday Night Raw. Maivia then successfully defended the title against Helmsley at In Your House 13, Final Four. He had his first WrestleMania match at WrestleMania 13, where he was victorious in his Intercontinental Championship defense against the Sultan. WWF fans started to reject his character and push from the company. He defeated Bret Hart by disqualification in a title defense on the March 31 episode of Raw is War. Behind the scenes, Hart mentored Johnson for his first year in WWF 48 and refused to be booked to take the title from him. On April 20, at In Your House 14, Revenge of the Taker, he lost to Savio Vega by countout but retained the title. Audiences became increasingly hostile toward Maivia, with chants of Die, Rocky, Die, and Rocky Sucks being heard during his matches. The Nation of Domination, 1997-1998. After losing the Intercontinental Championship to Owen Hart on the April 28, 1997 episode of Raw is War, and suffering a legitimate knee injury in a match against Mankind, Maivia returned in August 1997 and turned heel for the first time in his career by lashing out at fans who had been booing him and joining Faro Oak, D'Lo Brown and Kama in the stable called the Nation of Domination. He then refused to acknowledge the Rocky Maivia name, instead referring to himself in the third person as The Rock, though he would still be billed as Rocky The Rock Maivia until 1998. The Rock would then regularly insult the audience, WWF performers, and interviewers in his promos. At D-Generation X, In Your House, Stone Cold Steve Austin defeated The Rock in under 6 minutes to retain the Intercontinental Championship. The next night on Raw is War, Austin was ordered by Mr. McMahon to defend the title in a rematch, but forfeited it to The Rock instead, handing him the title belt before hitting him with the Stone Cold Stunner. The Rock feuded with Austin and Ken Shamrock through the end of 1997 and beginning of 1998. On January 19, 1998, at Royal Rumble, The Rock defeated Shamrock by disqualification to retain the Intercontinental title. Later that night, he entered the Royal Rumble match and lasted until the final two before he was eliminated by Stone Cold Steve Austin. On March 29, at WrestleMania 14, He defeated Shamrock by disqualification once again to retain the title. The next night, on Raw is War, The Rock debuted a new Intercontinental Championship design and would later overthrow Faroka's leader of the Nation of Domination to spark a feud between the two. He then successfully defended the Intercontinental title against Faroka Over the Edge, In Your House on May 31. The stable would then refer to themselves as simply The Nation. The Rock and The Nation then feuded with Triple H and D-Generation X, with the two stable leaders first meeting in the quarter-final of the 1998 King of the Ring tournament, which The Rock won. At King of the Ring, The Rock defeated Dan Severn in the semi-final match and lost to rival Ken Shamrock in the final. The Rock then resumed his feud with Triple H, as the two had a 2-out-of-3 falls match at Fully Loaded. In Your House for the Intercontinental title, which The Rock retained in controversial fashion. This led to a ladder match at SummerSlam, where The Rock lost the title. The Rock saw a big uptick in fan support during this time, causing him to be booked in a feud with fellow Nation members Mark Henry and D'Lo Brown, turning babyface in the process. Henry defeated him at Judgment Day, In Your House, after interference from Brown, effectively breaking up the stable. WWF Champion and Rise to Superstardom 1998-2000. The Rock was then entered into the Deadly Game tournament for the vacant WWF Championship. The finals occurred at Survivor Series, where The Rock defeated Vince McMahon's associate, Mankind, to win his first WWF Championship. A double turn then occurred as The Rock turned heel again after allying with Vince and Shane McMahon as the crown jewel of their stable, The Corporation, after the McMahons betrayed Mankind. On December 13, 1998, at the pay-per-view named after him, Rock Bottom, In Your House, The Rock had a rematch with Mankind for the WWF Championship. Mankind appeared to win the match when The Rock passed out to the mandible claw submission move, but Vince McMahon ruled that since The Rock did not tap out, he retained his title. The Rock continued to feud with Mankind over the WWF Championship, which was traded back and forth between them. First, in the main event of the January 4, 1999 episode of Raw is War, Mankind defeated The Rock after interference from Stone Cold Steve Austin. Then, in an I Quit match at Royal Rumble on January 24, The Rock regained the title, when a recording of Mankind saying I Quit from an earlier interview was played over the PA system. On January 31, during an episode of Sunday Night Heat, Mankind pinned The Rock using a forklift truck in an empty arena match to win the WWF title. This match was referred to as Halftime Heat as it was televised during halftime of that year's Super Bowl. The two faced off again, at St. Valentine's Day Massacre, In Your House, in a last man standing match which ended in a draw, meaning Mankind retained the title. Their feud ended on the February 15th Raw is War, when The Rock won his third WWF Championship in a ladder match after Big Show interfered on his behalf. The Rock then lost the WWF Championship to Stone Cold Steve Austin at WrestleMania 15. The Rock's popularity continued to grow and audiences still cheered for him even though he was a heel. He then lost the title rematch against Stone Cold Steve Austin at Backlash. In Your House after he was betrayed by Shane McMahon, turning him face again and starting a feud with Triple H, The Undertaker and the Corporate Ministry. On April 29, 1999, WWF aired the pilot episode of SmackDown, a term derived from one of The Rock's catchphrases.